Hey guys, this is Hanzo from Devoted Gaming with our walkthrough for The Walking Dead. Hey guys, welcome back to The Walking Dead walkthrough episode 2, Starving for Help. We just got out of the woods. I almost chopped the guy's leg off, but I chose not to because, oh my god, I would have like puked probably. I would have disgusted. We're back at the motel, everyone fought over food, blah 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 blah. So I guess I should start talking to people. No, I'm not giving Ketchup food.
Is he gonna be okay?
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick?
Sure, what do you need?
Sure, what do you need?
Just apply some pressure here while I try to close this up. You know, I thought I was starting to get used to this, sewing up people's injuries. What were you thinking, bringing him here? Even if he lives, we aren't going to be able to take care of him.
That's what your husband wanted,
It's what your husband wanted.
Figures. I love that man to death, but I swear sometimes he's dumber than a bag of hammers. Well, you've done all you can, Lee. Thanks for the help.
Just like his son.
Go ahead and check in on the others. I need a little space here anyway.
Dumb as a bag of hammers, just like his son. hey. What's that?
Leave it to Doug to rig up a warning system out of garbage.
Well, that's the difference, I guess.
Hey, Doug.
What's up, Lee?
What are you working on?
What are you working on, Doug?
I've worked up a little warning system for outside.
It's just some strings. How does it work?
How does it work?
I set up trip lines at 4 locations, and each one triggers one of these 4 bells. So...
So we'll know where they are and how long we have. Smart.
Think Kaja can save that guy?
Think Kaja can save that guy?
Maybe. I mean, I know about computers, but that doesn't mean I can fix a calculator.
But you probably could fix a calculator.
Well, yeah. Good point.
You know, I'll think about the
Take
food
easy,
situation
Doug.
Later.
You too, Lee.
Well, he's doing something constructive, so far he kind of deserves a piece of food. I'm definitely giving one to
Will
Clementine.
Will you hold the damn board steady?
I'm trying. I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout? Oh, I got 60 cents in my pocket, if you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
I do not like Larry. Seriously, I'm gonna make sure.
Hey, will the kid make it?
I don't know.
You know it was an accident, right? I didn't mean to shoot him.
I know. It was crazy back there. Kid acted stupid.
So I'm guessing we found a smart guy recently and gave us food since we let him join us or
you
something.
You ever miss the Air Force base? I mean, this wall isn't exactly military standard.
No way I'm going back there. You saw what it was like when you guys picked me up. Completely overrun.
So we meant about the airbase. Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Well, what did she want us to do? Just leave a couple of teenagers to the walkers?
That's exactly what you should have done.
I'll think about
Need
giving...
any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. You mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Give the axe to Mark. Look, hell, I'm gonna give the Mark. I'll give it to Mark.
Here, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work over here. You didn't think to give me the axe?
Come on, Larry. Cut Lee some slack. He knows you're just out to protect Lily. He told me so. Just like he's trying to protect Clementine.
I just need some food. Going this long without a proper meal make anybody cranky.
Oh, so I guess I chose the right option to say that, you know, you're protecting your daughter. So he backs off about it. Good to know. Oh, sucker ball.
At least the kids have something to keep them occupied.
Yeah, as I say, I'm probably going to give food to Clementine, that's for sure.
How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Of course.
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
He's like, oh man, Duck. No, Clementine is pretty smart. She dragged the kid away because she knows that, you know, get him out of trouble. She's pretty smart. I'm like, this is a stupid, dumb kid. Let's finish talking to her. Is there anything else? You still have that walkie-talkie.
That thing doesn't work anymore, does it?
No, not since it broke at the drugstore.
Just gonna hold on to it then?
Yeah, if that's okay. I need it.
It's okay, hon.
You said you didn't think they would find us.
Well, yeah, but that's just because...
But we can try to find them.
Look, Clementine.
I'm not stupid, Lee. I know it's just pretend. But it makes me feel better.
Okay, you take good care of it then.
I will.
She's such a smart little girl.
How you doing, Clementine? Everything all right?
Yeah. Is that man going to be okay?
He'll be fine.
I think he'll be fine.
Oh, that's good. I'm so hungry, Lee. I hope I get to eat soon.
Here you go, Clementine. I was always gonna give you food.
Here, Clem. You need something to eat.
Let's give you crackers and cheese. Kids like crackers and cheese, right?
Okay. A sundae would be better next time.
I'll keep that in mind.
If you have any more food, Duck is hungry too.
Yeah, why don't we go get some food?
Oh no, Duck. I'll tell this kid.
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Kaja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe we just left Mr. Parker there.
I tried. I really did. I just ran out of time. There was nothing else we could do.
I was not gonna chop his leg off, okay? So who are you?
So who are you people? Our group's gonna wanna know.
I'm Ben. Ben Paul. The guy in the truck is Travis. He played in the school band with me. Mr. Parker was the band director, but... God, I can't believe we left him.
How are you doing?
How you holding up, kid?
I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
You did all you could.
I'm sure you did all you could.
Yeah, maybe.
Relax. We'll get your friend back to normal in no time.
I sure hope so.
This kid's not as dumb as his friend Travis, who tried to grab a gun. Oh, I should talk to Lily. Can I talk to her? Yes, I can.
Maybe we should think about leaving the motel.
God, not you too. I know Kenny wants to leave. I think that's why he's so eager to get the RV working. But this is a good spot. We're protected, we're close to the drugstore, we have a routine now and it's working.
For now.
Let's talk about you and Kenny.
We should talk about you and Kenny.
What about us?
They're arguing. It's getting pretty out of hand. You know people notice that.
Look, I'm working my ass off to make sure we have a good setup here, and Kenny just doesn't appreciate that. All we need is food.
But there is no food. You know that better than anyone.
Well, we'll just have to find some.
You know what, Lily's actually okay.
Fine.
In my opinion, she's okay. It's just that her dad's a complete butt. Oh, hey, Duck. I should technically give him food. He's a child. And I think Kenny would appreciate if I gave him food. I'll think about
it. How you doing, Duck?
I'm okay. Me and Clementine are coloring.
Guess what it is?
I don't know. A dog?
Nope.
Oh, I know. It's a goat, right?
No.
You were pretty brave when we brought those people in here.
That's because I know Mom can fix him.
You know, I should. I think Kenny will appreciate me giving food to his stupid kid.
Hey, Doc. How about a little food?
Give you crackers and cheese, too.
Here.
Yeah! Oh, man, I'm so hungry!
There we go, you appreciate it. Good. I'm not giving anything to Ben, because I just met. I don't know if he's actually going to be cool or not. You know, I think I'm going to give it to Doug. A piece of food to Doug, because, you know... Give food to Duck.
Hey, Duck. Don't suppose I could interest you in some food.
He's so happy. Here, have a piece of jerky.
Actually, Why don't you keep my share today? I know I said it didn't matter why you saved me and not Carley, but I owe you a lot more than half a day's rations.
Hey, if Doughboy doesn't want his food, hand it this way.
It doesn't work like that. I'll decide who gets the food.
Well, decide smart. You don't really want to piss me off, do you?
But Doug, honorable, I must say. Should I give Katja or I should Kenny first? Oh, come on. Walk through the thing.
Word's getting out that you want to leave the motor in.
That ain't no secret, Lee. It's probably our best bet.
I'm not sure that's the best idea.
You gave Glenn your blessing when he left. Just asking you respect my choice as well.
Yeah, but he was leaving to find his friends. Your family's right here.
Well, here isn't doing us any good. You should think about coming with us, you and Clem.
The Costas, I want to leave, because, you know, Kenny's all right.
Coast does sound like a smart idea. Maybe that is the best thing.
I know that it is. I'm taking my family.
I'm not done talking to him, am I? Or... Oh, how about the guy in the bear trap?
The guy in the bear trap? You think we gave up too early? I think if I just had another minute or two...
You saw that guy? His leg was completely mangled. Even if you got him out, what then? I had my family in mind, and you gotta think of Clementine. We gotta stay alive for them.
Right, but yeah, you know, the lady's kinda right.
There's a point about these new people being extra mouths to feed.
I know, but maybe the problem isn't that there isn't any food, there just isn't any here. We gotta think about moving on.
Let's hope things turn for the better. Soon.
Now there's a statement I can get behind.
Okay, well, I don't think I'm going to give any food to Kenny. I think he'll be alright without food. But I probably will give food to Katja because she's the one taking care of us if we get her. So she needs her energy. So I guess the dog piece can go to her.
Here, eat something.
Why don't you give it to Doc? I'm a little busy with your mess right now. I need space, Lee.
Okay, fine. I'll give you food then. Okay, I guess... You know what, I think I will give food to Larry, because, you know, I don't hate Lily, I just hate Larry, so... Oh, I can talk to Larry, I didn't talk to him yet.
You've got to talk to Lily about getting along with Kenny.
Lily can make her own friends.
It's not about making friends. We're all in this together. We gotta start acting like it.
Stuff all that. We'd be fine without you.
Lily wants to ditch new people.
Lily thinks we should throw these new people out.
Damn right. There's too many people hanging around here as it is.
Should give him food. You know what? I will.
Here, Larry.
But you don't deserve anything healthy. You know, give him a piece of jerky. Give you more of a heart
Lily
attack.
I want you to keep your strength up.
That girl needs to quit worrying about me so much.
You made a tough choice.
Oh, man. Just seeing the food is driving me crazy.
There's one piece of food left. I'm not keeping it. I'll save the last piece for someone else.
Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones that need it.
I'm sorry, Mark. I don't really know you that well. And I don't know the men kid very well. Guess I will give it to Kenny. I took care of Lily's father, and she will appreciate that. But before I do, I'm pretty sure after I give the food, there's a cutscene, and I'm running out of time. So... I'll stop the video here and I'll resume as soon as I can. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.